We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey, so make sure you guys have your teacups ready because this tea is what? Piping hot. Good morning, teen. It's your girl, T, and I hope everybody's doing good today. So now everybody named Mama Honey been sending me requests to talk about this new show that's getting ready to premiere called The Real Side Chicks of Charlotte. Yes, this thing has the internet buzzing. Everyone has been talking about this from Rihanna to Snoop Dogg to Cardi B to The Shade Room, Media Takeout. And initially, a lot of people thought it was fake. We all thought it was just a fake show. It seemed like it was mirroring The Real Mistresses of ATL. If you guys remember a few years ago, Memphis, who is Toya Wright's ex-husband, he was supposed to be producing a show called The Real Mistresses of Atlanta. And that show never took off. It didn't, you know, see the light of day. And it seems like somebody else has come up with a new concept. But now the women behind The Real Side Chicks of Charlotte and the guy who kind of started everything went down to the radio station called WPEG, which is one of the biggest black radio stations in Charlotte. So they met with No Limit Larry and Miss Jennifer and they did a sit down interview. I want you guys to watch a small snippet of their interview. Go ahead and check this out and I'm gonna come back with the rest of my commentary.
A lot of people don't know that the show actually came about from my big homie 704, who's live in the building. What's up, 704?
Hey. What's happening?
So it kind of started like a video, like a concept right. For a video, and you can take it from there.
Actually, me and my boy Trails was just trying to promote the song, you know what I'm saying? So we came up with a little video from the Real Housewives of Atlanta, put it out there. We put it out there and started getting feedback that was crazy, like more than what I do when I put my records out. You know what I'm saying? And it was just a lot of interest in people wanting to see it, making comments and all of that. But my homeboy from LA who actually shoot movies seen it, and he called me, he was like, yo, you're a genius, you got a crazy idea. I'm like, what you talking about? He was like, the new show. I'm like, what show? He like the Real Side Chicks of Charlotte. I'm like, nah, man, that's just a promo video for the song. He was like, nah, it's a reality show now. I'm coming. And from there, we here.
All right, there it is.
Ladies, I know that you all are receiving a lot of backlash. I want to ask you all, why do you all want to be known as side chicks?
It's not so really much as what we want to be known as. It's just, that's how it goes. Like, you might look at it as a side chick, but I look at it as a main chick as well, because I'm getting the same treatment as you. So
right.
We can go
big
sideways,
facts.
Left, up, big down. Facts. So we can do all kind of side of a chick. But
right.
If I'm getting the same treatment, it's not really the same qualifications of what you would call a side chick, because you just don't like it because it's our man.
Exactly.
There are women that are like, you all are homewreckers. You all are tearing up families and happy houses. How do you all feel about that?
I mean, it's not that we're tearing up homes or that we're tearing up, you know, happy houses or whatever you want to call it. It's just at the end of the day, are you doing what you're supposed to do for your man?
Right.
You know? Are you doing what you're supposed to do to keep him?
Right. Why should we be called the side chicks when your man is the one coming to us? We're not going after him. Mm-hmm. He's the one coming to us.
All right. So you guys just saw that interview. And a lot of folks want to know my opinion about this entire situation. Now, if you guys have been on my channel for any length of time, you guys know that I spent most of my adult life in Charlotte, North Carolina. After I left high school, me and my high school sweetheart, we moved down to Charlotte. You know, we were teen parents, so we moved down there. We didn't know a lot of people, but we ended up meeting people, and people became like family and coworkers. So I spent about 10 years of my life down in Charlotte before I ended up moving back to Minneapolis. So with that being said, this show definitely hits home. And I will say this, don't let that goddamn Southern hospitality bullshit fool y'all. Some of the biggest hoes are in the South. I just got to keep it real. I know my people in Charlotte might get upset. Y'all might get offended, and I don't give a damn, okay? Some of the biggest whores I've ever met are in the South. For some reason, I understand there's not a lot of men to go around in cities like Charlotte and Atlanta and things like that. And a lot of women are very comfortable and happy with being the side chick. This is not a new phenomenon. I worked in corporate America in Charlotte. And I know a lot of my coworkers will watch this video and they will laugh because they know what the hell I'm talking about. When I tell you damn near everybody in that office, besides me and a few other people who actually respected their marital vows, were fucking everybody. I mean, there was all types of drama in this office. You know, employees fucking the manager, employees fucking the AVP, people getting pregnant, wives sending sheriffs up to our job to hand over divorce papers, DNA tests. It was so messy. You guys cannot understand how much nonsense goes on in corporate America, not just all over the country, but especially in the South. Literally everybody in our office was screwing everybody. It was a hot damn mess, okay? So on top of this, like I said, I got married in the city of Charlotte, and my ex-husband ended up finding his side chick in the city of damn Charlotte. You know, and I can kind of laugh about it and joke about it now, because we've been divorced now for about 5 years, and, you know, I've grown a lot, and I've taken time out to heal. You know, my dad wants me to get remarried, and my mom and my mother-in-law. You know, you guys know I'm very, very close with my ex-husband's family. I still call her my mother-in-law, even though me and her son have been divorced. I literally talked to her at least a few times a week. I spoke to her yesterday for like 2 hours. Like, that will always be my mom. She's known me since I was 16. Like, we were high school sweethearts. So it's like, I'm always going to be close with his family. Me and his sister still call each other sisters. His nieces and nephews still call me auntie. So as far as the immediate family, they don't even pay his new girl no attention. They all still show me love and respect. So I will always be close with his family. And they're all rooting for me to get into a new relationship and to get remarried. And my dad really wants me to, you know, find a husband. And, you know, I'm praying that eventually I do find a good husband. But I don't know. Like, I don't trust anybody anymore. Like, when you're with somebody from the time you're a teenager and you put so much into your relationship and you just want to be a good wife and a mother, and they end up literally just shitting on you, you know what I'm saying, and getting with somebody else and playing you. And the thing is, like, a lot of these side chicks have no respect. You know, they'll call your phone and talk shit. It was such a mess. And I've even had friends of mine in Charlotte who were side chicks, and they were fucking with other people's husbands and going over to their house and bragging about how they didn't have nothing on underneath their coat but some lingerie, you know, harassing the wives. I mean, it's a really, really sick mentality that goes on down there. So I am not shocked at all that this show is called The Real Side Chicks of Charlotte. When I tell you at least 90% of the people down in Charlotte have that mentality, they really do. Either you're getting played and cheated on, or you're that other girl. This is why these women have no shame, because this is honestly the attitude that a lot of people down there have. And they're just exposing what's been going on for years. And I can attest to this. You know what I'm saying?
What is that, bitch? You want, bitch? What you want to expose, bitch? That took your husband? You want to expose that took your husband, bitch?
Bing. We got that. Bing. We got that. Bing. We got that. We got that. We got that. We boom, boom, we got that. 5, 6, shot.
To me, it's a disgrace. You know, it's sad that we're so willing to promote stuff like this. And it's sad that WPG, who's supposed to be a respected, prominent black radio station, would promote and support the degradation of the black community and the black family. You know, and this is why I understand why a lot of young girls don't want to get married. This is why I understand why a lot of young men are like, you know, I'm cool. You know what I'm saying? Why marry somebody when I can get the milk for free? This is why a lot of people would rather be players than be in a monogamous relationship. You know, I'm to the point where I don't even know if monogamy is possible. I don't think any man is faithful. And people get mad at me all the time. I don't give a shit. I've been through it. You know what I'm saying? I don't think any man is faithful. You know, most guys are only as faithful as their options. And if a chick throws something at them, they'll have sex with it. And that's how I honestly feel. And I'm not going to act like I don't feel that way just to appease some people in my audience. You know, if you have a good man or a woman, hold on to them tight, honey, because these bitches swear up and down, you're not doing something right if he chooses to start fucking with them. What people don't realize is that you can be the best wife, you can be the best husband, you can, you know, sleep with that person every night, do all types of sexual shit, have threesomes, do all types of dumb shit that Tiny was doing, be ride or die, and a person can still play you. Period.
I just want to piggyback off of something you said, Dewey. You said she's a ride or die. I love that whole vibe.
You know, I was with him before he was T.I. You know, he was, you know, trying to make it at the time. I mean, he had like an album out, but it didn't do too good. So he wasn't like really successful. So, you know, when I got with him, we kind of grew. He grew as we were together.
You left and went and got a house somewhere else.
Because you started to
had some infidelities with a girl who I hired, and that girl is one of the reasons why I got my own house.
I feel that the marriage is distracting me from my greatness.
You have to respect your woman.
You know, so at that point in time, you have to ask yourself, what is your self-worth and what are you willing to put up with? And for me, it just got to be too much and it wasn't worth my dignity. It wasn't worth my mental stability. And I got the hell up out that relationship. As hard as it was at the time and as much as I was depressed and hurt behind it, I can say now looking back, I'm glad I went through that because I know now what I would not put up with. And it also makes me not be in a rush to get into a relationship, you know. But like I said, eventually I do want to settle down and find a good man. But I'm not going to, you know what I'm saying, just settle down with any and everybody. I'm not desperate to have a man. I'm not about to sit here and mess with a married man or a man in a relationship just to say I have a man. So a lot of this stuff falls back on the women to me. You know, I feel like as women, we set examples for what people are willing to follow. And because so many women do not respect the sanctity of marriage, don't respect other people's relationships, why would we then expect the men to? If the women have no respect for themselves and they're willing to hold themselves out for a man, you know what I'm saying? They're willing to be the side piece and they're willing to do this for like trinkets. And some of y'all bitches don't even get anything being the side pieces. These girls claim that they're getting all types of jewelry and they're just as important as the main chick. I know bitches fucking the manager at Bojangles and they're not getting nothing but a 4-piece meal, okay? So everybody ain't just coming up from being the side piece. Some people are just content to say that they have a man in their bed and they have somebody they can call their man. And it's really sad. And I think women who have that mentality have an extremely low self-esteem about themselves. You know, I just think it's really sad that we've gotten to this point just in the world. Like there's no morality anymore. Everything that's good is bad and everything that's bad is good. And the fact that this is being promoted so heavily, and we wonder why the next generation of young girls would rather be on Instagram, wanting to be Instagram models, wanting to be side chicks, wanting to get money the fast way, not really wanting to be in a relationship. They just want to have sex and get paid. This is where this type of mentality leads to, and this is why the next generation of girls and guys has such a messed up, warped mentality on what a relationship should be. You know what I'm saying? We're not seeing any images of a healthy family. We're not seeing any images of healthy marriages. Literally, everybody's getting divorced. We have the whole situation going on with T.I. and Tiny. You know, so many people just separating, breaking up, and a lot of it is due to infidelity. A lot of it is due to, you know, these side chicks and women being happy to be on some man's beck and call. So I find the whole situation sad, but not shocking. I've been through it, and this is, you know, the dirty secret of Charlotte that people don't necessarily talk about. And Charlotte, you know, they want to act like they're the Bible Belt and everything is just so bougie and pristine. And, you know, we're in the South and Southern hospitality. Don't let none of that bullshit fool you. If you're in the South and you're in Charlotte and you're married, you better hold on to your husband or wife tight because this is what they do down there. I am living proof of this. This shit to me is just comical because I'm not shocked by this at all. And it's not just Charlotte. They do the same shit out here in LA, do the same shit in New York. You know what I'm saying? But it's very big in the South. And the reason why people don't tend to look at the South as being like a hoish type state is because it's the Bible Belt and people are always thumping on their Bibles and they'll be fucking your man Friday through Saturday, but then be in the church talking about hallelujah, praise him. You know what I'm saying? But then be smashing the pastor and the deacon. Honey, The South is a hot damn mess. I love it, though, but it is a hot damn mess. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire crazy situation concerning the side chicks of Charlotte. Are you guys disgusted by this show? Are you guys wanting to see it? And then how do you feel about side chicks in general? And have you guys been in a relationship or a marriage where, you know, your significant other, you know, either your wife or your husband, ended up getting a side chick playing you and cheating on you and eventually led to y'all breaking up or getting a divorce? So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right. Deuces. Hey, you guys, it's your girl T. Make sure to subscribe, like, and share my videos. You can also visit lovelytea.com to purchase any merchandise. Also, don't forget to click the boxes down below to watch any of my previous videos. Talk to y'all later. Deuces.